Hey, this is Rob and Abity and Melissa behind the camera with Adventure IQ. We're up here on our annual Thanksgiving trip, and we're going to do another one of our traditions, which is my apple cobbler. And to do that is very simple, especially in the backcountry. We use the jumbo biscuits. We use apple, what is this, this year? The Duncan Hines Wilderness, more fruit apple. So Wilderness works out really well out here. And this year I'm gonna do something a little bit different, and we're gonna put in just a little bit of crushed pineapple to make it pop a little bit. So we're gonna go ahead and start with putting a little bit of oil in as Abby gets that biscuit container open for us. And we've already seasoned the Dutch oven here. This is a number 10 Dutch oven, and I like to use a little bit of oil in it. And even though these will burn on the bottom, which is okay, it's gonna happen.
Holy crap, that was loud.
We're then going to put a good base of oil in there. And then I just take my biscuits. Melissa, go ahead and come on up here. I'm just laying the biscuits in, and I want them touching all the way through. And what's nice about the jumbo is that they'll flake up really, really well. And inside this number 10, it covers just about our entire area. Now what's interesting is that you can also make pizza the same way. Now, as those cook, they'll begin to swell, and yeah, we'll have some apple crisp down at the bottom. Because the sugar in the apple crisp, that does cause some of the burning, and that's all right. I'm gonna take my white spoon. I'm just gonna shovel this in there. And again, it's two cans of biscuits and two cans of the apple. So the first one in there. Put our second one in there. And you can use apple, you can use cherry, blueberry, any kind of sweet fruit. And when I do put this on the fire, we want to make sure that we don't make the coals too hot or put on coals that are really, really hot. Okay, there we go. Just like so. I'm gonna spread this around, make it real even. And then we're gonna put in just a little bit of the pineapple. I'm gonna be careful not to use the juices, a whole lot of the juices, because we're gonna add the juices to our bird this year. Go just like so, and again with the juices, because the sugar will cause it to burn if we're not careful. So we're going to take that next batch of biscuits, and we're just going to cover the top. You could, if you wanted to, make this a triple layer, put another layer of fruit on it. It's kind of fun if you use a different fruit than your first layer. And then what I would do differently is on the last layer of biscuits is I put my little cross hatch work on it. That's done. We just need I've got one more. I'll just shove that right in there. And all we need to do now, all of our biscuits out of here. Good, we've got all of our biscuits used. And then we just need to season up the top. And then as soon as we pull off our main course to start eating, we throw this on. I cook it until you can smell it. So that's one of our holidays. Rob and Abby and Melissa with Adventure IQ. Hope you're having a great Thanksgiving. We are out.